Good morning, good afternoon, evening, or even good night, depending on where in the world you are watching this from. Today, we'll take a look at white cells and how to identify the five main types on the blood film. That's the neutrophils, lymphocytes, monocytes, eosinophils, and basophils. We'll dive into greater depths in a subsequent video. I'll also cover immature forms at another time. So let's start. If you watched the Introduction to Red Cells video, the link is in the description below if you haven't, you'll have seen this clip of a wet prep before. A drop of blood was placed on a glass slide, a cover slip put on top, and the blood viewed under the microscope. The blood is not stained nor has it been fixed. You can see the red colour of the erythrocytes, or the red cells, due to the hemoglobin. The immobile white cell, which has been marked with the arrow, doesn't really seem to have a colour. We can make out some granulation due to the texture of it, but that's really it. White cells gain their beautiful colours that we are so used to seeing once they have been stained. One of the ways we can separate the white cells is by their granulation. Those that have intracellular granulation are called granulocytes. Neutrophils, eosinophils, and basophils would fit into this category. You'll notice there's an asterisk. Though monocytes have very fine granules, they're not usually visible under the microscope, hence why I do not like to refer to them as being a granular. On a side note, neutrophils are sometimes referred to as polymorphonuclear cells, and the monocytes and lymphocytes as mononuclear cells. You probably want to see real pictures rather than these cartoony ones on the right. I knew you were going to say that, so let me show you some of those. Okay, so here they are. Let's talk through each of the cell types and some of their distinguishing features. Before we start, the images are not drawn to scale. Just so you can see them properly, I've cropped them to be the same size. In the granulocyte box, the first up is a neutrophil, or the polymorphonuclear cell. The neutrophil has a nice multi-lobed nucleus, and usually it has 3 to 5 lobes. You can clearly see there are granules within the cytoplasm. The granules are fine, and when you see the other granulocytes, you notice the neutrophil granules are the finest of the lot. Next up, we have the eosinophils. Their nucleus normally has 2 to 3 lobes, but just like the neutrophil, it can be hypersegmented or hyposegmented in certain conditions. The most distinctive feature is the reddish-orange granules within the cytoplasm. The granules are larger than those in the neutrophil and spherical in shape. The last cell in this category is the basophil. What I love about the basophils is the deep purple, almost black coloured granules that cover the nucleus. For all the three of the cells mentioned, changes in granulation can be seen in different conditions. Let's move on to those cells without granules, or should I say granules that are difficult to see in comparison to the granules within the granulocytes. In the blood, you'd normally find two types of lymphocytes, the small ones and the big ones. The small ones are about 80% of the circulating lymphocyte population, and you guessed it, the rest, the 20%, are the large ones. Pictured here is a relatively small lymphocyte. You can see there's a high nuclear to cytoplasmic ratio, and though not visible, the nucleus would be roughly the size of the red cells. Some lymphocytes may even have much less cytoplasm. Last, but by no means least, we have the monocytes. The monocyte is the largest of the normal white cells. The nucleus is irregular and lobulated. It is often described as being kidney bean shaped. The cytoplasm is greyish blue and can contain vacuoles. Monocytes often have an irregular shaped cytoplasm and contain very fine granules. All the images you have seen so far of the cells have been somewhat resized to make them all the same size. In reality, however, the white cells are all different sizes. They tend to be generally larger than normal red cells. However, the cells may vary considerably in certain conditions. Before we start, let me remind you that a normal red cell is approximately 7 to 8 micrometers in diameter. It will help you compare the size of the white cells with the red cells. Okay, so first up we have the neutrophil. The neutrophil is 12 to 15 micrometers in diameter. The eosinophil, which follows that, is roughly the same size, being at 12 to 17 micrometers. The basophil is the smallest of the three granular sites and has a diameter of 10 to 14 micrometers. The lymphocyte is the smallest of the white cells altogether, being at approximately 10 to 12 micrometers. If you remember, the nucleus of the small lymphocyte is roughly the same size as a red cell. Lastly, we have the monocyte. The monocyte is the largest of the white cells and is 12 to 18 micrometers in diameter. In reality though, you'll notice that there's a lot of overlap between the cells, and when you look at the cells under the microscope, they'll all look about the same size. Thank you for watching the video. If you found it enjoyable and informative, please do give a thumbs up, and if you loved it, hit the subscribe button below.